Tucker.
Tucker, Deacon St. John. Deacon St. John to Ada Tucker.
Deke, did you find her?
Yeah, Tuck, I found her, and she's on her way back.
What? You let her go? Alone?
She took one of the squatter's bikes. She said that she was going to be able to find her way. She didn't want my help.
Oh, God damn it, Deke. You should have brought her in.
Well, why, Tuck? Why? Is something wrong? I mean, is there some reason she wouldn't want to come back?
No, of course not. It's just a kid like Rose, she doesn't have a goddamn clue about what's out there.
Well, I don't know, Tuck. Maybe she does. St. John out.
Hey.
It's okay.
You want to die out here? Look, there's a camp.
A camp? Yeah, where? Yeah. I'll go.
Peaceful Lake. Mark Copeland. It's safe there.
Thank you. I thought I was going to die.
Tell him it was St. John, Deacon. They know who I am. Now just keep running, stay off the road. Fuel. Here we go. Done.
So, you want to learn how to hunt? Is that what I'm hearing?
I know how to shoot a gun.
It's a rifle, not a gun.
I was in the 10th Mountain Cope. Don't give me any Marine Corps bullshit.
Killing a buck's a little different than killing a man. Or a freak. The best way to hunt an animal is to track it. You gotta focus. And see what nature's trying to tell you. If you look hard enough, you'll see the signs.
Okay, then. Look hard. See this pile of deer scat? It's fresh.
Yeah, I see it.
They lead this way.
Yeah, I can see that.
Well, come on, man. Quick, there's your buck.
I see him.
Now here. Use my rifle. If you were in the 10th Mountain, you know how to use a scope.
Yeah, Cope, I know how to use a scope.
Easy, easy.
I got this. Oh, God damn it, it wasn't a kill shot. He got away.
No, that's okay. You wounded him. He'll bleed out soon enough. You just gotta track him.
Okay.
See the blood spots? Look close.
Yeah, I see him.
Then follow him.
On it.
He'll be slowing down about now. Losing too much blood. We should be coming across his carcass anytime now. Okay, you know how to gut an animal?
Yeah, look. Cope, Boozer and I have been hunting before. He used to go elk hunting with his old man, and yeah, he showed me how to gut a deer.
Well, let's just say, no disrespect to Boozer, but you got a lot to learn. You're wasting a lot of meat there. Overall, not bad for a beginner.
Yeah, thanks.
Now, I'll take back that rifle.
Here, thanks.
Like I said, Deke, we can always use more venison at the camp. Still got some folks trying to heal up from that Ripper attack.
Okay, Cope. Yeah, I'll see if I can remember that.
Let me get the gate.
Hey, been seeing you around more.
Manny.
You suppose the freak can feel anything?
Hey.
You know, from before. Like sad and happy and shit.
Hell, I don't know.
Deacon, hey.
Damon, how's it going?
You definitely need that. That'll last you. Come by any time. Stop by any time.
Seen everything you done for the camp. A lot of folks alive because of you.
Camper's life, hey Manny.
You looking for something? You don't want to run out of fuel in the ship, that's for sure.
Oh yeah, that's a good piece. I'll wrap that up for you. Cool. Need anything else? I'll be here. Later, man. Deacon, how you been?
Hey, Manny.
Should have more stuff later.
See you around, Deacon.
Deacon, hey.
Thanks for that, Chris.
Damon, how's it going?
Ooh, time for venison stew? And we
what? Not enough credits?
Everyone.
See ya, Deke.
How's it going, Booze Man?
Supplies. Could use some more meat if you get a chance.
Oh, shit. Okay. Guess it's been a while since we did any hunting. I'll see if I can scare up some meat while I'm out.
You remember what you're doing?
Yeah, I had Cope give me a few pointers, believe it or not.
Cope? Shit, I don't believe it. Thanks, Steve.
See you, Booze Man. All right, now I just gotta find some meat. Deer, bear, wolf. Oh, fuck, don't matter to me.
Good night. Got him.
Okay, let's take a look around. Back on track. This is it. What do we got? Gotcha. Got it. See what I can do.
Thank you.
Hey, booze man. I brought in some meat. Should keep us stocked up for a while.
Hey, Deke. Thanks, man. I'm not real hungry right now. I'll salt it up in a bit.
This has got to be it.
On approach to the landing site, I observed a large swarm of insects, probably Demonocitronus or Pantera, in a clearing well away from our designated target. From that distance, I could not discern what was attracting the insects, but from the size of the swarm, recent carrying is indicated. Should be just over here. Damn it, where is it?
Where you poor son of a bitch. At least you weren't torn apart by freaks. If you lived a few more weeks, you might have become one yourself, and whether that meant something. What do you want? Stay back.
I just want to talk.
Nero, Protocol 2-7 states clearly that if conducting operations in quarantine zones, if I encounter any civilians or civilians that I'm forbidden from making contact.
Really? See, that sounded to me like making contact.
Yes. Yes, it did.
You're alive.
Yes. I am.
How? How are you alive?
What? I don't understand.
Okay. You were there. That night. Farewell. The next night, refugee
Nero
camp.
Protocol 2-7 states.
Everyone was dead. They were slaughtered. Torn limb for goddamn limb. All right, listen up. We're going to do this the easy way or the hard way. The easy way, we have a little chat. You give me the information that I need, and then you go back to digging your way through freaker shit or whatever the hell is you're doing out here. The hard way. I crack open that little space suit, and then we see what your friends out there have to say about you breathing in all this contaminated air. So what's it going to be, O'Brien?
Yes. Okay. Okay.
You remember the rooftop of the old brewery? I put a woman on your chopper. She was wounded.
Yes. I remember. A knife wound. She was cut pretty bad.
I went to the refugee camp that you said you were taking her to. Everyone was dead, so I'm going to ask you again. How did you survive?
We weren't there. We were diverted south to another camp. Like you said, the camp in Belknap was overrun, so they moved us south to a camp outside of Silver Lake.
Were there survivors?
You mean now? I don't know. I was transferred to the research unit.
Did she survive?
Oh, wait. I can find out. I can check. You have one of our radios. That's how you... I can't promise anything, but I'll check.
Uh-huh, and I'm gonna go with you.
No, you can't. Please, you don't. Hey, don't understand. I'll fucking shoot you.
Not before I shoot you.
Okay, look, if you're gonna fucking kill me, do it, okay? I did my job. Did that woman, your wife? I put her on oxygen. I gave her an IV. I kept her alive. I got in a lot of trouble for that. She was septic. She wasn't gonna make it, but I got out of the mass unit. I saved her goddamn life.
O'Brien, report.
I have to go. Please, you have to get out of here. You don't know these men. You don't know
Ryan,
what they're capable of.
If I don't hear from you, I don't care how long it takes, I'm gonna track you down. And I'm gonna do a lot worse than snap off an antenna.
I'm sorry about your wife. But you're not the only one who lost someone that night.
Man, a few days ago, I asked you if you remembered that Nero asshole.
Yeah, Deke, it's all kind of a blur.
Yeah, okay. Get some shut-eye, Booze Man. I'll tell you about it later.
When are we riding out of here, Deke?
Soon, Boozer. Real soon. Look, as soon as your arm heals, we're gonna be riding the hell out of here.
If you want to swing by.
Boozer, thank you. Yeah, I'll stop by later. There, O'Brien. Oh, son of a bitch. Yeah. Oh, you son of a bitch, you better radio me. You hear me, O'Brien? I know you're on this channel. Okay. You better get back to me. Oh,
you better radio me. You hear me, O'Brien? I know you're on this channel. You better get back to me, or I'm going to track you down. You got that? Oh, God damn it. Come on, Brian. Get back to me.
Oh, what the hell? It's worth checking out.
Deke, you there? Did you track down the chopper? It's the same guy that was on with the night.
Yeah. Yeah. It was him.
You remember us? Sarah, what happened?
I don't know. They got diverted south. He remembered her, but he doesn't know what happened to her.
I don't think she's still alive.
No, look, I'm not stupid, loser. I just want to find out, you know, what happened to her. Where she died.
Hey, maybe you can finally find some peace.
I don't need to find any peace. I gotta go, all right, Deke? I gotta go, all right? Deacon out.
Low on ammo. Can of fuel.
St. John, this is Copeland. Manny says he's got a part for your bike.
Not sure I have enough camp credits.
When you do, swing by. He'll fix you up. Copeland out.
That's it.
Deacon St. John, this is Mark Copeland. I just wanted to apologize for that business with your bike. After the things you've been doing to help out the camp. Guess I had you figured all wrong. Again, I'm sorry. Products from around the world? We got the shittiest products cheap foreign labor could churn out. Everything in the last 50 years was built to break, so that you could buy once, buy again, buy. You always had to get the new car, the new phone, the new this and that. All to feed the beast of crass commercialism. You want something built to last? You couldn't go overseas, nope. You need real, hard-working Americans at the helm. When we build something, it'll stand the test of time. And the same hands that built this country, they'll withstand anything this new world throws at us. Our roads bend, friends, but they do not break. And neither will we. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
They look pretty broken to me, Cope, but hey, whatever you say. Nothing wrong with a little crass commercialism. Hell, I could use a new bike right about now.
Treehouse to use as a deer blind. Getting height on your target helps your aim and keeps you safe. Back then, I took out my first doe from up top. Today, my camp's up in the trees. You want to survive and can contribute, you come to me. We got you covered. Grandfather also taught me to catch a doe, sometimes you gotta lay an ambush. Hide where they need to go, like a watering hole. Today, you're as likely to be prey as hunter. So you gotta keep your eyes peeled when you're hitting up places we all need to go. But Grandfather always said the easiest way to a good meal was to lay a trap. Put a snare by a tree, and you could have dinner next time you come round. But careful. A headless snake can still bite, especially when it ain't really dead. My grandfather would have outlived us all, let me tell you. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Well, that's great, Cope. So you and your granddaddy set traps for him, and you and your old man used to lay down salt licks. Yeah, it's real sporting. I guess none of that shit matters now.
Hold on, I'm coming.
You're not gonna make it out here. I know where there's a camp.
Where? I'll go! Peaceful Lake. Mark Copeland. It's safe there.
Thank you so much! I thought I was gonna die in there!
Tell him it was Deacon. Deacon St. John. Keep your head down and run!
I never knew that.
This should work.